हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज सोमिल पटेल. वंस अगेन दिस साइड वेलकम्स यू इन माय ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम, पीएलसी ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम ऑफ द टोटल इंटीग्रेटेड ऑटोमेशन वर्जन 15.1. ओके, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ द प्रोग्रामिंग. ओके, एंड द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ द प्रोग्राम विच इज यूज टू डेवलप दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम, टू डेवलप एनी पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम. ओके, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. Okay, first we will open our program, which is in the practice folder and which is named by the practice project. Okay, and to open this program, we have to double click on this project file. Okay, just wait for 5 to 10 seconds. Okay, the window is opening, totally integrated automation portal v15.1. Okay, so the today's session is going to be awesome. Okay, we will cover all the types of fundamentals and concepts which is really important to use, to develop, and to understand the program, to understand the PLC program. Okay, to develop the PLC program. Okay, so like NC contact, like NO contact, like output coil, we'll discuss about that. Okay, so our program is opening. Okay, it's opening state right now. It is in opening state. Okay. So in output coil, timers, counters, move instruction. Okay, so this type of concepts we are going to discuss in the today's session. Still it is in opening mode. Actually, there are too many blocks which are, which is very useful to develop the program. Okay, but today we are going to discuss about the important fundamentals. Okay, about the important concepts to develop the program. Okay, so our window will open. Okay, our window will open while clicking on this open project view. Okay, our project window will open by clicking on this open project view. Okay, and let's wait for 5 seconds. Okay, now our project is open now, and in the left hand side there are two compartments. One is the PLC and one is the HMI. So we will go into the PLC section. And in the PLC section, there is another compartment of the program block. Okay, we will go to there. Okay, and our program will start from the main block. Okay, our program will start from the main block. Okay, so the main block, which has the address of OB1, which has the address of OB1. So we double click on that main block. Okay, so we have to start the programming from this main block. Okay, this is the main routine of our programming. So all the stuffs which we will program, okay, we have to call them into this particular block. So these all the programmings can be fetched by this particular main block. So our main block means you can say that without main block there is no program into the PLC. Okay, without main block there is no program into the PLC. If your main block is empty, then there is no program into your PLC. Okay, so whichever you have developed the program, that should be called into the main block. Okay, so okay, we'll discuss the concepts. Okay, first of all, we will take the NO contact. Okay, NO contact. So make your note to understand the concepts in the future also. Okay, so first of all, we will take the NO contact. But before that, here you will see the network. Okay, the network. So in the program block, in the main block, or in any program block, you can create the multiple networks. Okay, suppose I right click on this network, okay, and I will insert the new network. Okay, I will insert the new network. So the network 2 is open now. Okay, so the network 2 is created automatically. So it is used to generally it is used to separate the logic. Suppose in the network 1 you have the pump logic. Okay, pump program logic. In the network 2 suppose you have the wall logic. So by this putting this comment you can segregate your logic. Okay, you can segregate your logic network by network. Okay, so this is use of this multiple networks. Okay, so this is the comment which I have given to the network one. So we will develop the pump logic over here and we will develop the wall logic over here in the network two. Okay, first of all we'll discuss about the NO contact. So suppose here you can see there are some contacts are available over here. Over here some contacts are available over here. Suppose I am using this NO contact, I will drag and drop this NO contact to this rung, okay, to this network, to this line. Okay, so our NO contact is incorporated into this network. Okay, our NO contact is incorporated into this network. Okay, suppose I am using this NC contact. So this is the NC contact. So suppose I am using this NC contact besides this NO contact. Okay, so the NO contact is now incorporated into this network one. And the third one is the output coil. The third one is the output coil. Suppose I drag and drop this output coil and I insert it into this network. So it is automatically at the end of this rung. So this is called, this line is called as a rung in the talkable way as far as the automation is concerned. Okay, so rung it is nothing but a network. Rung it is nothing but the network. So in this rung we have incorporate one NO contact, one NC contact and one output coil. Okay, so the NO and NC contact are used generally, it is used for the input purpose. Okay, and this output coil is generally used for the output purpose. Suppose you have two buttons. Suppose you have two buttons, one is the start button and one is the stop button. Okay, to start particular pump, to start the particular pump. Okay, so that start and the stop button will be your input to start the pump, and the pump itself is the output. Okay, pump itself is the output. Okay, so by pressing the start and the stop button you will start the pump. Okay, so the pump is the output and the start and stop button will be your input. Okay, so for NO and NC contact are always used for purpose of input signals, that input signal, it can be your digital input signal, it can be your particular SCADA input signal, it can be your particular HMI input signal, or it can be your push button input signal, it can be your button input signal over the HMI like start and stop button. Okay, it can be your hardware input signal. Okay, so this type of concepts we are using into the program. Okay, so this type of concepts we are using into the program. Okay, suppose in the network 2 let us take one NO contact over here. Okay, and let us take that fourth component. Okay, this is here you can see the question mark. Okay, over that component, or that means this is the empty component. Okay, so suppose you drag and drop this empty component over the rung of the network 2. Okay, so this component is added, this instruction is added into the network 2, but you can see this is the question mark. Okay, so in this question mark you have to double click and you have to write the particular instruction. Suppose I am right now using the move block instruction. Suppose I have write down the move move block. Okay, and enter. Okay, and enter. So I am using this move block to store the particular value from the left hand side to right hand side, from the left hand side to right hand side. Okay, just consider I am using one instruction which is named by the move. Okay, don't confuse for these concepts. Okay, first of all we will discuss about the digital concepts. Okay, digital concepts like NO NC contact, NO contact and output coil. Okay, let us delete this move block. Okay, to remove the confusions. Okay, to remove the confusions. Okay, suppose now. Okay, and let us remove this NC contact also. Okay, to for better understanding to create the program, right? Suppose you have a switch. Suppose you have a switch to start and stop the pump. Okay, when you enable the switch, your pump will start, and when you disable the switch, your pump will stop. Okay, so for storing the particular switch signal. Okay, so when you on the switch, the signal will be one. When you off the switch, the signal will be zero. Okay, so it is the digital type signal. It is the Boolean type signal. Okay, so we have to create one tag to store that particular switch value. Okay, so in our previous sessions we have developed one Boolean tag. Okay, so like this way, in this session we will develop one database with data block. Okay, in that we will create some tags. Okay, which will store the particular values, which will store the particular values like the means you can add the data block over here by pressing this add new block. Okay, by pressing this add new block, here click on the data block. Okay, and pump db. Suppose you are putting the name like pump data block. Okay, pump data block. Okay, and you press the okay. Okay, so your data block will be created over here, which has the address of db3. Okay, suppose you have only one switch and you have only one pump. Okay, you have only one switch and you have only one pump. Okay, suppose for storing the switch signal, which is the digital signal. Okay, it can be on and it can be off. So this is the digital signal. Okay, so by storing the digital signals, okay, we have to create one tag like pump on off switch. Okay, pump on off switch. Okay, and which has the data type of Boolean also. Okay, which has the data type of Boolean also. And pump, and we will create the one another tag which is called as a pump running. Okay, so by enabling that switch, your pump will run, and by disabling that switch, your pump will stop. Okay, so we will store your so we will use this pump running tag. Okay, to run the pump, to run the pump, we will use this pump running tag to run the pump. Okay, so the pump can be run or pump can be stopped. Okay, so this is also a Boolean data type. Okay, this can be also a Boolean data type. So these two tags we have created, these two tags we have created. Okay, and we will use these two tags in our program. Okay, so let us move to the main block again. And suppose I'm giving here, this is the NO contact. Okay, so if this NO contact will, if NO contact is goes to one, then our output coil will be enabled. Okay, if this NO contact is goes to down, then this output coil will be disabled. Okay, so suppose I am using I am using. So this is the red question mark. It is the address of this NO block. It is the tag of this NO block. Okay. So the tag of this NO block, it is nothing but the pump DB, pump on off switch. Okay. Pump DB, pump DB, pump on off switch. Okay. So we have to write the address. We have to write the tag over here like this. In the pump DB, enter dot pump on off switch. Okay. So like this way, we have to address this. We have to attach the tag to this NO contact. Okay. And this is the output coil of the pump. Okay. So by enabling and disabling this output coil, our pump will run and our pump will stop. Okay. So we have to attach the tag pump DB dot pump running. Okay. So when our switch is one, our pump will run. When our switch is zero, and our pump will be off. Okay. At that time, the pump running status will be zero. So this is called as a NO contact concept and output coil concept. Okay. NO contact concept and output coil concept. Okay. NO contact and output coil concept. Suppose this is the concept of NO and output coil, but let us consider some NC coil concept. Okay, let us consider some NC coil concept. Okay, so for that, we will take the example of the two buttons, start and stop. Okay, we will take the example of these two buttons, start and stop. Okay, so for that, we will go to the pump DB block. No problem. I will create one another block. Okay. And we will take the example of the valve open and the valve close block. Okay. So this is data block of particular valve. Okay. Here is the valve DB. Okay. So the in the left hand side, you can see that DB4 valve DB is created. Okay. So the tags which is related to the valve will be created over here. Okay, suppose open the valve means you can open the valve or close the valve. Okay, close the valve and valve valve output. Okay, valve output. Okay. So we have created the three tags to open the valve. One is the open button which has the tag of open the valve. One is the close button which has the tag of close the valve, and one is the actual output. Okay, to on and off the valve. Okay, so this valve output tag is connected to the actual valve output. Okay, so let us make the program of that valve. Okay, let us make the program of that valve concept. Okay, suppose while pressing the valve open button. Our valve should open. Okay, and while pressing the valve close button, our valve should close. Okay, so for that we will introduce one another concept, which is set and reset concept. Okay, so for that we will take NO contact to open the valve. Okay, so for that our tags are in the valve DB block. Okay, so in the valve DB dot open the valve, so that will open valve DB dot valve output, that will open our output. Okay, but as far as the pump is concerned, we have used switch. Okay, when you on the switch, it will remains in the on condition. Okay, so when you on the switch, it will remains in the on condition. Okay, when you off the switch, it will remains in the off condition. But over here in the wall logic, we are considering the buttons. Okay, when you press the button, okay, it will give the signal 1 to the PLC. But when you release the button, okay, it will give the signal 0 to the PLC. Okay, so this NO contact, will once 1, will be once 1 and again goes to 0. Okay, while clicking on this wall open button, okay, so when you press this button, this will the wall DB open the wall will be 1. Okay, and your wall output will be on. Okay, so this is okay, but when you release that button, your wall will be closed. Okay, so this is not the right condition. When you press this open, then wall will be in the open condition. Wall will shoot in the open condition. So for that, we are using set. Okay, so once it is pressed, it will set this wall output. Okay, it will set this wall output and it will remain in the set condition. It will remain in the set condition until and unless you will reset this wall output coil. Okay, so for the reset, for resetting this wall output, okay, you have to press this close button. Okay, you have to press that close button, the close wall output button. Okay, for example, I copy this network 2, so the network 3 will be automatically created. Okay, and suppose I am using the NO contact of the close the wall tag. Okay, so by pressing this close button, okay, you have to reset this output coil. So this both output coil has the same tag, okay, which is called as a wall output, but one is a set condition and one is a reset condition. The set condition is depending on the open wall and the reset condition is depending on the close the wall. Okay, so the logic, how we can understand this logic? Okay, so here there are two buttons. One is for opening the wall and one is for closing the wall. Okay, when you press this open wall button, your output will be set. Output will be set, means it remains in the set condition. And when you close this wall button, your output will be reset. Okay, that means by opening and closing, your actual wall output, your actual wall will open and close. Okay, so by using these two buttons, open and close, we will able to make this actual logic, actual functional logic of our wall. Okay, and so in these three networks, we have understood the logic of the NO contact and output coil, set coil and reset coil.